Jackson has had his eyes widened, his nose repeatedly narrowed, and the fat sucked from his lips. He's also had a Kirk Douglas dimple put into his chin and a wider forehead constructed. Strangest of all, though, his skin's been artificially lightened into a sort of international beige.
Michael Jackson. It's safe to say that he did have a love for plastic surgery, and as a result of his changing appearance, made him the focus of tabloid scrutiny and ridicule. The reality is, though, that for much of the 1990s and into the 2000s, it was largely because of non-invasive changes, as well as the effects of his ongoing health issues, that his appearance seemed to have changed so dramatically, and not as a result of cosmetic surgery. Welcome to The Detail, and in this video we are going to list 5 little-known ways, other than plastic surgery, Michael Jackson altered his appearance throughout his lifetime. And if you like this video, please make sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this one. Also, we love to get your input, so please leave a comment if you have any additional info that we didn't quite cover here. We are always up for getting more of the detail. Now, first on the list, makeup. Because of Michael Jackson's vitiligo condition, a disorder that destroys the pigmentation and leaves pale white patches on the skin that spread over time, Michael Jackson used heavy stage makeup. In particular, pan stick foundation that would be used to cover up large dark patches to even out his skin tone on a daily basis. Now you have to remember that this makeup is really heavy and removes any subtleties to the skin. And outside of a photo shoot or a film studio, this would look incredibly artificial. On a woman, but more so on a man, and especially a man that has lost all his natural pigmentation to his skin through his condition. In conjunction to this, Michael Jackson also heavily contoured his face, in particular his nose and his cheekbones, to add definition so not to appear so washed out, adding the appearance to his nose that it was much smaller and pointier than it actually was. Michael Jackson also wore eyeliner, lipstick, pressed powder on a day-to-day basis, which would further add to his androgynous image. Number 2. Tattoos. Not only did Michael Jackson have vitiligo, but in 1984 he was also diagnosed with lupus, an autoimmune disease that causes a high risk of infection, skin rashes, and hair loss, including eyebrows and eyelashes. As a result, Michael Jackson had them tattooed on. After his death, the autopsy report revealed that Jackson appeared to have his lips, eyebrows, and eyeliner tattooed on. The contrast between his pigment-depleted ivory skin and his very dark, permanent makeup tattoos resulted in an alarming, unusual artificial look that he had day to day. Number 3. Hair pieces. In January 1984, pyrotechnics accidentally set Jackson's hair on fire while filming a Pepsi commercial, causing second-degree burns to his scalp and extensive hair loss to the top of his head. Michael Jackson endured through a series of painful surgeries to help heal his burns, including a number of tissue expanders to his scalp, which consist of balloons that blow up, expand the skin on the scalp, with the hope of stretching the skin over and cutting the scar tissue out. Hats have to be worn during this period, and because of this, the fedora became a signature for Jackson. But, unfortunately, because of Jackson's lupus condition, these surgeries were never a success, and the bald spot would keep enlarging. The only alternative for Jackson was to wear wigs, which he did for varying degrees for the rest of his life. He also had his scalp tattooed black to hide his injuries, as well as his receding hairline later in life. Number 4. Weight loss. At the time of Michael Jackson's death, he was measured at 5'9" and weighed 136 pounds, which is within a normal weight range, although very thin, especially for a man of 50 years old. Jackson's dermatologist, Arnold Klein, said, "I knew that he always wanted to be thin, and I talked to him about eating enough and making sure that he didn't over-exercise." According to his costume designer, Michael Bush, Jackson would lose so much weight during a concert, due to the loss of water, that the costumes Jackson wore at the end of the show would be smaller than the ones that he wore at the beginning. Usually, he was a 28-inch waist. Although throughout Michael Jackson's life his weight didn't dramatically fluctuate, he did go from slim and athletic to a somewhat thinner and more fragile frame, which would make a dramatic difference on Jackson's face, giving him an often gaunt appearance and accentuating his already sharp and defined features. And number 5. Drug use. Adding to this gaunt appearance, Michael Jackson is known to have begun his addiction to painkillers after suffering his burns while filming the Pepsi commercial. At first, he reportedly refused to take painkillers, choosing to deal with the intense pain himself, but then eventually submitted as it became too unbearable. This decision leading him down to a road of drug addiction that would eventually result in his death in 2009. Like anyone suffering from a period of deep drug dependency, there were periods where Jackson appeared particularly gaunt. He lost weight, his features hollowed out, and his eyes seemed distant. An issue that was rarely acknowledged in mainstream press and was largely unknown to the public at the time. Thank you for watching The Detail. And if you like this video, please make sure to give us a thumbs up, share with your friends, and subscribe for more videos like this one. Also, we love to get your input, so please leave a comment if you have additional info that we didn't quite cover here. We are always up for getting more of The Detail.